Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can use Power Query to create buckets or groups in Power BI. Stay tuned. If you're finding this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right. So buckets and groups, there's a couple of ways you can do it. Before I show you what I did in Power Query, let's talk about typical ways that people create buckets. So the first way, number one, what I suggest is you do it in the source. So if you have access to the source, if you know someone that's building your data model in the source, reach out to them and say, hey, can you create my buckets for me at the buckets as part of your ETL process? And they'll probably be happy to do that for you. If you don't have access to the source, you got a couple of choices. I'm going to show you two of the common ways, then I'm going to show you the Power Query way. You guys know I like to do enough of all this talking. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. If you don't have access to the source, another way that I see people do it is they use DAX. And typically what they do is they'll create a calculated column and do something like this. So they'll use switch or if or something like that and say, if the age is less than this, give me this grouping. If it's between this, give me this grouping, and on and on and so forth. And then what they do is they create a sort by column, usually something to sort it by. They drop it, and now you can see how it's in those buckets. If I enable drill, if I go 21 to 40, you can see that's all the ages that's between 21 to 40. If I go to 81 to 100, you'll see that's all the ages that's between there. So they use DAX, and it's a calculated column. And if the column had a lot of high cardinality, it could affect the size of the model. It could affect refreshing and things like that. But this is such a low cardinality, it's definitely an option you can consider. Not the first one that I would consider. Another one is you can use the grouping feature inside of Power BI. Let me show you what I'm talking about. You could go to the age or whatever column you wanna add this grouping to, right click on it and you'll see new group. Or you can go in column tools and you can choose data groups. Either way, we'll give you the same context menu. You can give it a name. Oh, this is my age groups. Spinning won't work in this situation because it doesn't give me the ability to specify those really neat labels that I want. So I'm gonna change from group type from bin to list. And then what I would do is go select everything that I want and say add a group. And then watch this, I can add my little label. So I can say 20 to 40 and then continue on and so forth with my grouping. Let me show you one that's complete looks like. So we'll go here and we'll edit this group. And you can see how I have the groupings. And if I expand one, these are the values that'll be included in that group. And once I create it, if I go over to my group page and then I just drop my age group here, you can see I get my nice labels and everything just kind of works nice and tidy. Three ways: source, DAX, you can use grouping. But then I was in Power Query and I said, let me try something out, and it actually worked. Let me show you what I'm talking about. So I have my age, and then I went to add column and I chose column from examples and I chose from selection. Watch this. Let's just do 20 to 40. What do you think is going to happen? Boom, look at that, 20 to 40, 40 to 60, 80 to 100. It automatically knew what I wanted. If I put it in any range, let's say I want to be in intervals of 10. If I do 30, 40, look at that, 40, 50, 70, 80, it just works. Now, if you don't include the value in your range, it's not gonna work. So if I do something like 10 to 20, it doesn't know what to do. So I gotta make sure that I include that value. So if I do 21 to 40, it gets close, but if I just give it a little more information, 41, to 60. Now it does everything for me, right? 21 to 40, 41 to 60, 81 to 100. And I can say, this is my age group PQ. If you look at the top here, you can see it's writing out that M for me. So I just click okay and boom, watch, let's go. Once it does its work, if I click on my dropdown, you can see all the groups that it created for me. If I click go home, choose close and apply, it's gotta reload that customer table. While it's loading that customer table, just know adding this could slow the performance down because Power Query does need to run that logic over the data or new data that's introduced into the model. So once it's done, hang on, I'm gonna go over to that page and then I'm gonna click on the bar chart here and then it added there and boom, now it works. I have my sort by column and it'll sort it up properly. If I drill through, you'll see how everything works. What? Is that bananas or not? I had no idea Power Query, the add columns feature in Power Query, was that powerful. All right, what do you guys think? How are you doing your grouping? Are you having, you using DAX? Are you doing your source? Have you tried this trick out? I'd love to know. Let's continue the conversation. Where? In the comments below. If this is your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, two big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.